Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to all of you. So, there is a saying that only one thing is for certain, and this is the happening of change. Everything is always changing, no? And the Osho, he used to say, the one who will succeed spiritually and also in his other life circumstances is the one who can adapt to change. So there is change and there is also the opposite of it, and this is silence. There is a silence which is around everything. There is a soundless sound. As my singing teacher in India used to say, there is a soundless sound. And that is the perfect description of what this silence means. It is not dead. It is not just silent. It is sounding, but there is no sound. So when we can adapt to these changes, that is the first thing we have to do, because earth, our earth, which means our circumstances, our life situation, is always the first thing we have to react to. Now we have to answer to it. This is why we are embodied. We are first of all bodies, and we have to interact with earth, with our life situation. And if we lose ourselves in this interaction, if we have only this interaction, then we find all kinds of troubles. But if we anchor ourselves in silence, in this silence which is surrounding everything, which is all the time present, beside this noise which is also present, there is this silence. And if you come to that silence, to this inner silence, you find that these waves, which are in all our lives, everyone has these waves. There is not an ocean without waves, no? So we are in the ocean of life. That means we are all in these waves. Some have typhoons, some have tsunamis in their life. But thanks God, many have just common waves, let's say, no? And we want to find this ideal situation. This is the idea people have about their life situation, that everything has to be ideal. So when there's these happenings coming, wars, climate crisis, economic crises, health crises, all this attack, always our addiction to the ideal situation. We want to have it ideal. And existence teaches us moment by moment there is not an ideal situation. There will be not a situation ever which is ideal. So there is also not an ideal relationship. There is not an ideal parents. There is not an ideal work. There is not an ideal political party. There is not an ideal country. All that is not. There is not an ideal spiritual path. In every spiritual path you will find points that will give you kind of conflicts or kind of things that you don't know how to deal with it. No? So there is nothing, absolutely nothing ideal. At the same time, everything rests in the silence and is in the highest perfection, in the highest precision, in the highest love. This silence has, first of all, the quality of love. It's a silent love. And then on the other side, we have the loud love. We have the love which is noisy, which fights with each other, which is afraid to be abandoned or to be betrayed, or all these things that can happen in love relationships. And at the other side, there's this silent love, which has no threat, which has no minus, which has no deficiency. It's fulfilled. And that love is not a love to a person. It's not a love to somebody. It is a love to what is behind all existence. And you can name it as you like. Some name it the Great Spirit, some name it Supreme Intelligence, some name it God, some name it Allah, some name it whatever, no? And there is no shame in naming it also, yeah? There's not something you have to excuse for if you say, I have faith in God, you know? There's not something that you have to defend. And also it is not something that you have to explain. When you find faith in your life, when you find this connection, even it might be just in the beginning a mental connection, whatever it is, on which level it is, it doesn't matter. You will find a satisfaction with it. And don't allow anybody to take that satisfaction away from you. Don't go in a discussion. Don't try to explain or to defend yourself if people are not happy with your faith. And there will be always knockers and mockers. Yeah? There will be always people, they disagree with you or they see the thing in the opposite way. It is not on you to explain anything. You have the right. It's your birthright, it's our birthright, to walk the path that fits for you. And if it is your path to be alone, for example, to live a celibate life, to live a life which is remote, then this is your path. And there will people come and say to you, you oppress this or you oppress that. And even so, it is still your path. So, not all of us can have the same path. Actually, everyone has a different one. But you can follow, we can follow the truth. In this we are common. The truth unites us. If we have the intention for truth, even the factive truth, but more than that, the higher truth, the inner truth. If we have that intention, we will become a humanity, we will become a collective, we will become healthy. If we do not have that, we will not reach there. So, this is why the next time is called in the Eastern tradition Sat Yoga, which means it is the time of truth. In other traditions it is called the age of balance, of harmony. And in some other traditions it is called the golden age. Yeah. So more or less they express the same in different words. And we have to see only ourselves. This is the duty we have. We have to respond to ourselves and to see our mistakes and to see our lies, to see our misbehaviors and to try to correct them. That's all. And when you are belonging to this kind of group, that you want to be a straight person and you want to be a person who is ready to see their own mistakes and to take responsibility, then you will experience a shift within you. And that means you will be not as touched from any kind of situation which happens on the surface in this planet. You will not be touched in the same way, not emotionally, not mentally, not physically. And this is a secret that cannot be explained. It's a mystery. Yeah? And it has been appearing in many stories in our tradition, the Sufi tradition. There have been many stories told that people who were protected in very, very, very strong crises, in apocalyptic situations, they were protected. Yeah. And this will always be. There will be always people who will be protected. And they are protected not because they are rich, or because they are strong, or because they are smart. No, they are protected because they have a love. At the end, the only thing which really protects us is not strength, it's not power, it's not military this or that. What protects us is love. And when we come to love for the one who loves us, for the being or for the isness, it is so difficult to describe it, but there is a love around, and that love loves us, that love speaks to us, that love addresses us, that love cares for us. So when you fall in love with that love, yeah, you will also find yourself protected. And that should be your faith. So faith is the road to love. Faith is the road to truth, to be in balance. And to reach there, we have to surrender. There is no other way. We have to surrender what is not truth. We have to surrender what is not love. We have to surrender what is not correct, what is not pure, what is not straight. So everything what we have now, we actually have to surrender it. Because you can see we're living in dirt. We're living in a dirty environment. Not only on the level of earth, of the pollution of the earth. That is one. But we are living in a very dirty level of what happens on earth. What we do to the weakest, how we treat each other, we are on a very, very dirty and low level. So do not think that we will be protected there. No. Some will be. Most no. Unless they do not repent and they turn around, it will not happen. And you can think this is a kind of blind belief or blind doctrine or whatever that is, whatever you want to call it. No. The rules, they apply anywhere you will be born, in any dimension you will come. Never you will be able to escape from truth. And nowhere you will find a place where the love is not on you. When you realize that, you can stay calm in the middle of the storm. And remember the story of Jesus when he was in the boat and they were in a storm, him and his disciples. And the boat on top of that had a kind of leakage and the water came and the storm was tremendous. And they saw Jesus calm. He was totally calm in the middle of the storm. And they asked him, how can you be so calm? And he said, how can you have so little faith? Don't lose your faith. Don't lose your faith, whatever there is, whatever in the movie happens, don't lose your faith. There will be a happy end because the source is happy. The source is bliss. The source is love. So there will be a love end. There will be a happy end. But the end, what the end means, this is in the secret of the divine. So we all end individually in our described time. So the end is not collective. It is only individual. If you have an individual end, make sure it's a happy end. And my master used to say, you have to train only for one moment. And this is the moment of your death. Make sure that you live the life that when death comes to you, and death comes to you with judgment, because it's Saturn, it comes to you with judgment. It is the moment where you have to face yourself and where everything is unveiled. Even you try to veil it all your life from yourself, it will be unveiled that moment. So he said, make sure that you unveiled as much as possible, and that you took responsibility, that you could forgive as much as possible. And that you have faith. Keep faith. If you want to do something good, be friendly with those who need help, especially to the children, especially to the weak ones, to the elder ones, to those who cannot take care for themselves. And we are heading now in Ramadan. Ramadan is the holy month, it's the month of humanity. And in this month, we try to exercise, to practice, especially what means to be together. So we share our food, but we are fasting. That is a very big point. We are fasting. And fasting means we are not only fast from food or sexual activities. We fast from, for example, shopping. We fast from consuming unnecessary things. We are fasting. We are fasting from backbiting. We are fasting from being fearful. All these things are very easy in Ramadan to do. This is the magic of this month. So you may not be a Muslim, you may not consider yourself as a religious person. That's all right. But you may try to fast because it has to do with the moon. And you do not have to believe in the moon because the moon is in front of us. For example, this moon is a very strong moon, very, very strong moon that we are now going to experience. And tomorrow night there will be a special night, it's the night of destination. So for those of you who are not in this tradition, it is still a night which will count very strong. And you should try to stay awake. If you can pray in your way, if you can be silent in your way, if you can be inward in the way you know, that will be very, very, very beneficial. So we wish you a very happy night. And you are the smith, the goldsmith of your own life. This you have to understand. So take this power and act. Act in your life. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to all of you.